episode 447, podcast number 311. Thank you so much for joining in. My name is Todd Ansich. With me, I have my friend Gavin Sharma.
You're taking that liberally. I am not your friend, but I am here, and it's Behind the Bunker, folks. Everybody who's watching right now is my friend, so make sure you hit like and share, because that's what friends do.
Except for you, and you know who you are out there.
That's right.
And then we have Joe Kimson from Flaggers Paintball.
Hey, and thanks for tuning in tonight to beautiful Behind the Bunker, and our picture's gone. Our screen is gone.
That's okay. Matt's just toggling between things.
I see a mountain.
We ain't stressed.
447 pot shows and 311 podcasts.
What?
Crazy.
That's stupid.
447 nonsensical episodes of Behind the Bunker.
And three good ones.
Two, really. I think the one that you had a little extra airtime, you keep thinking was good, but it ain't.
My mom said it was.
You did look handsome in that episode.
I'm only in half.
Oh, it was a good show.
So thank you guys for joining us. We will have Josh Subizabrikas joining us shortly. Unfortunately, he was talking to some people from China recently outside, so I don't know if we'll see him or not. But
he was giving them the Canadian greeting of a French kiss.
He's got French-Canadian. He has a Lithuanian flu.
So yeah, hopefully we'll see him shortly.
Yeah.
Why I'm taking a moment as well is I'm hitting that like and share button so that people can know that we are live.
Lovely.
Right now.
I think I'm going to do some liking and sharing. I liked it last week when you guys talked for like 3 minutes. I was able to share it to like a million different places, but not right now.
Well, we can do that. Right now I'm popping out the YouTube chat. I see guys in there right now as
popping
well. Nice
out.
To see Aaron and Teddy, Kevin, and where is the rest of you? So we'll wait for you guys to join
Lisa
us.
Lisa Weaver's there. Good evening from Team Tags and home of the meat stick.
Boy Scout meat stick.
Boy Scout meat stick. Yeah. What is that? Where's my bell?
There's nothing else as sticky as a Boy Scout's.
That's enough.
So devilish.
So, all right. I think all the nonsense is over. Let me get down to business here, guys. So coming over to my computer, tonight we're going to be talking about what is your... sorry, Matt. I don't know why that's not working.
It was earlier.
It was, and it should be now.
There we are.
Let's take a gander. No, just a nice mountain view.
It's lovely.
I had a minute. There you go.
No, you don't see my images anymore?
I do not.
For the love of Pete. Okay, so we'll try it in a minute. So today, we'll just get through it. What is the best and worst pieces of paintball gear you've ever had?
That sparked a plethora.
Plethora. Good for you.
Plethora.
Yes. Yeah, a very infamous famous person told me about that word. Tune in tonight to win, ladies and gentlemen. Carbon Paintball Pod Pack. All you got to do tonight is the last episode, tag Carbon Paintball, tag Behind the Bunker, and tag a friend. That's it. That's all you got to do. And your name gets entered into our draw. And next Monday night show, we'll take everybody that's done that over the last 2 weeks. And we'll give it away to one of you guys.
Give it away now.
Give it away.
Yeah. Still nothing, eh, Matt?
All right.
It's scenic.
I am 192.168.0.1.21, if
that
makes
any
difference.
That's a lot of numbers
that
you just threw at me.
You like Rain Man? Tapioca pudding?
We are also, if my brain is like that, we are also going to have our call hotline open, 585-250-8968. So hopefully we'll be able to get to some of your calls tonight. So while Matt is fixing that... I'm not sure why. There's a great picture of Rocky Mountains whenever you go to it.
Oh.
Okay. Well, we'll work on it. So thank you guys for joining us. You are watching us live on Facebook or listening to us on a podcast or watching us live on Facebook, or you could be listening to us in syndication on the RTF Sports Network. We have changed names, ladies and gentlemen.
RTF, baby.
RTF Sports Network. You can hear us Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. or Wednesday nights at 9 p.m. if you're a little bit later on. So if you can't catch us here, catch us on the radio on RTF Sports Network. My God. So
Are you sitting in the air chair right now?
In the air chair?
Yeah.
No.
Live chair? No, whatever.
In the air chair.
You know, it's us radio guys who.
Radio guys. Yeah.
That's what I.
So it's funny. We've gone from doing, webcasts and shows, doing podcasts. We were on TV in the UK And now we're on a radio.
And like North Africa, there was a number of those African continent countries that we're big celebrities in.
With Desert Fox in World War II in Rommel? That North Africa?
Yes. In fact, I think Rommel did tune in.
Yeah, actually, he's my landlord now.
Yeah. Is he really? Wasn't he killed in a car accident?
No.
Stop paying rent.
Chad, tell us, Gavin, about the Prime Paintball TV experience we had.
So we were we had a number of episodes that we were broadcast in the UK. So it was paintball.tv. And so there was a week-long, basically, channel that was dedicated to programming at around the 8 p.m. mark
in Britain.
In England.
Sky TV. Wasn't it on Sky TV on the satellite?
So it was pretty exciting for us here at Behind the Bunker. We got to be celebrities for about 30 seconds. And it was broadcast in a number of markets, and one of our biggest markets was North Africa. So
for whatever reason,
they took a liking to Gavin. So
and Prince Andrew was on it, but he flatly denies it.
Yes, I don't sweat.
I don't sweat.
Yeah, so it was pretty exciting, you know, for paintball to be exposed to a different audience. So we got to do our regular shenanigans stuff. We shot about 6 to 8 episodes, and it didn't get picked up. Strangely, you know what? You can probably write the station right now, because what you guys tune into each week is what we did, but nobody else in the free world seemed to enjoy it. So I don't know what the hell to say about that. But it was exciting. You know what? Hey, Ma, look at me. I'm on TV. Look at me. I'm on the telly. I'm on the telly with some
crumpets. On the telly with my friend Gavin. What else do we talk? Oh, I've got something to talk about here.
Okay.
This is from Rick Chard at Paintball Extravaganza, which is coming up the end of February, the 17th to the
21st or something like that.
Maybe to Monday to Thursday. If you could throw out a reminder Monday night, the registration rates are going up February 3rd. The booking at the Crown Plaza does not guarantee availability on any or the room rate after February the 3rd. So if you are planning, considering, pondering going to Paintball Extravaganza, which I think is a fantastic idea and a good opportunity to meet, greet, and share your paintball knowledge with other like-minded individuals in paintball, airsoft, and lasers. Then you should go to Paintball Extravaganza in Memphis.
It is, you know what, I am ridiculously excited about this. It's going to be a full week of paintball and like-minded people talking about paintball, seeing new paintball stuff, walking past this particular establishment and going to Gus's Fried Chicken.
Gus's Fried Chicken. We're going to go and we're going to go to the pyramids at Bass Pro Shop Pyramid, right on the on the shores of the Mississippi.
Yeah, I
and
can't
we
wait
can
for that.
Stand and gaze across to see Arkansas. And if we walk a little south, we will be able to see Louisiana.
I would rather go to Arkansas.
Arkansas. Did you know that Arkansas is the United States' largest producer of rice?
I did not know that. That's fantastic.
That is some Arkansas trivia.
And to be honest, that's as close as I want to get to either of those states.
What? Really?
What, really?
What the hell's wrong with you?
I think we need to Uber across the Mississippi.
I agree.
Or walk.
I agree. I need to put my foot in the Mississippi.
If we're going to cross the Mississippi, I want to do it old school. I want to do it on like a river, like an old river boat.
Like Tom Sawyer?
Yeah.
Nice.
All right, Matt, try one last time. And if it doesn't work, we'll move on.
But I do want to. I do want to point out.
What do you want
that
to
was the
out?
Best bed ever. It
was
only
a
brief
bed.
Second, but
it was
I
good.
Enjoyed it. It's it's getting us into the festive spirit of Extravaganza.
Chris Junior Rossi says Gus is for the win.
Gus is for the win.
Chris Junior Rossi, where are you located?
And will you join us at Gus's?
Will you come to Gus's? They had really good dessert too.
I'm not a dessert guy, but
you don't like pie, pecan pie, some kind of pie.
I like pie.
Like pie. There's also a good donut place in Memphis, and I really what I missed when we went to Memphis last time is I missed Hush Puppies. I want to get some Hush Puppies.
Like Long John Silver's.
Like Hush Puppies.
Hush
Puppies.
Hush Puppies.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
I miss Long John
Me
Silver's.
Too.
Not the Hush Puppies were okay, but I like the Fall Off the Fryer Cracklins. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. So you sell this?
Yeah, you cannot forget the fish. I just want the breading, like little droplets of breading.
Yes, I want a boat of the trimmings.
Yeah. When I make some money, I'm going to open up a KFC franchise, but I'm just going to sell KFC skins. Single serving KFC skins. That's
I
it.
I want a dedicated seat in your restaurant.
Hey, and I tell you, the reason why Josh isn't here, he has training night, or it's his training day. He told us a couple weeks ago. It's just dawning on me now. I was expecting him to come in. I just forgot it was this week. Goddamn Zubrickus.
All right.
All right.
Well, Gavin's here.
I'm here too. I made the trip. I made the journey.
Yeah, yeah. So we have lost one of our pieces of equipment that our new intern has destroyed on us. So we have lost, I'm blaming Matt,
on a bunch of stuff.
Matt Mondew. So let me have a look and see what we can do tonight without that. So again, we're talking about the giveaway, guys. If you want the pod pack, Matt, maybe go through show us the video here so people know what they're getting into, and we'll re-explain the rules. So if you want this carbon pack, guys, the SC harness, as you see it in the video, although the one we have is not black, it is honeycomb, gray and black honeycomb, right?
And delicious.
So Gavin, if I want to win this pack, what am I doing right in this second? Or if I'm even watching in rewind?
Well, my friend, you need to tag Carbon, you need to tag Behind the Bunker, and tag one of your jackass friends to let them know what you exactly are looking to win this evening on Behind the Bunker. Carbon, Behind the Bunker, and one of your jackass friends, that can get you your brand new pack for this season.
Yeah, yeah. Lisa Weber wants to know, why do bread models even training? He's got to keep on top of those angles. Chicken skin sandwiches are pretty good. There's no such thing,
oh,
Christopher Pringle.
Gosh.
Please tell me.
That's only in heaven.
Oh, Dannon says it's basically fried cornbread. That's how he typed it out. So,
how do you say it?
Cornbread.
I imagine him saying it.
I only have on Facebook. I don't have the YouTubes.
Yeah. He was just telling me about his shrimp.
shrimp boat. Yeah. We can go to Louisiana. They have shrimp there.
Dan Black says that's the best pack ever. There we go.
It's a pretty exciting pack.
There's a place called Jackass Brewing Company. Did you know that, Gavin?
I
actually tagged it.
I would like to go to Jerkass Brewing Company.
Now that's speaking a brewing of Gavin. Company.
So,
in Lewisburg, Pennsylvania.
Since we don't have our news to get through, I'll go through real quick and then we'll get into some mail time.
Sounds good.
We have a topic we want to discuss tonight, and that is, what is the best and worst pieces of equipment that you guys have ever had? And I'd like to get into that shortly as well. Before, I want to say, we'll leave that one for next week. So we talked about extravaganza. Guys, tonight... tomorrow, the registration increases for Las Vegas NXL, so make sure you guys get signed up before that deadline goes over. Also, AirUps 2020 field packages, guys, are on super sale right now, $5,100. If you guys want to go over to AirUps and get yourself one right now, get them ordered for the season. If you're anywhere near Flaggarters Paintball tomorrow, we're hosting the time trials, the Hitman AirPal time trials. So come on out and see if you can beat some of the scores.
Gavin, are you coming out?
I am working.
So working on coming out.
That's right.
All right. Well, then why don't we get into our mail time segment, Gavin? We have a bunch of questions that you guys sent in. And Josh had one that we'll start with just since it was a visual. He says, what is your favorite time of year to play paintball? I kind of wonder if we're all going to have the same answer on that.
I am going to say mid-spring, nearing the...
No, you're wrong.
Summer season, so it's still cool. There is
green.
Lush. Thick welded leaves.
Thick welded seams, stainless steel branches. It sounds like an AirUps bunker.
That's
and why
right.
wouldn't you buy an AirUps bunker?
So that's me. It's late spring.
I like late fall because it's cold in the mornings, it's cold at night, but during the day you still get that nice warm afternoon. Start the day in a hoodie, end in a t-shirt, and then go back to a hoodie again. I don't know, I like that. Winter, okay, maybe one day a year I'll play in the winter. Like, that's all well and good. Summer is great, yes, I get it, but it's usually too hot and too humid where we are. So it's either that spring or fall, but more so fall, right, Gavin?
Are you serious, Clark?
Wolf likes
I
summer.
I am Sparky.
El Rojo likes the winter. Where's he?
What the? Well, yeah, it depends on what state he's in, right?
Wolf Critcho says the summer, but you got to put on a lot of sunscreen.
I heard Wolf Critcho likes the summer.
I think Wolf likes the summer.
Summertime.
And the living is easy.
Roger Weber with spring and fall. We said one. Come on, jerk ass.
You're being greedy.
Yes, let's choose one.
He has a tag for every he has a tag for every season.
Pick a season, jerk ass.
He has a fall team tag, a summer team tag, a winter team tag. Those his winter team tags are insulated to keep you warmer.
Hey, for those of you guys who are following along at home, Matt ordered something a couple of weeks ago, rather before Christmas. Has it arrived yet?
That is a negative.
A negatory. Okay. So hopefully by next show we'll have some showings.
I've been keeping my eyes peeled.
Very good. All right, we have some mail questions.
Yeah, we have a few. So this is the time where I get to rip open my sack and read some of the correspondence that you, my friends, have sent in. So our good friend, what? That's not
sounds
sack ripping.
Sounds kind of sticky.
All right, Ryan McGee wants to know, in your guys' opinion, what brand and or model of radio is best for team communications?
We've had good luck with the Puxings and Baofangs, which are actually Kenwood knockoffs. I think there's some recent rulings that have come down from the Canadian government
Canada,
that you're not allowed to import them or export them because they can be tuned to many other frequencies. But in my opinion, they seem to work well. The batteries work well. They're easily to program, and they're very reasonably priced. So my vote goes for the Puxing or the Baofang. Yeah.
And before that, we were using
Talkabouts.
Motorola Talkabouts. Yep. And that
Let's
was something you could get at Targets and Walmarts and for Gavin's Kmarts and, you know.
Ooh, a Kmart. A good byway purchase.
Gavin Shop Smart.
Shop S-Smart.
Yeah, and they were really inexpensive, and you could go to Radio Shack when it existed, or those Source.
Look at you.
And you could buy yourself an earbud and Vox, what do you call it? A
headset,
I guess, for pretty cheap that would fit into those. Very cost effective. Went on 3 AA batteries, lasted forever. And that was the workhorse for quite a number of years.
Yeah, they did it until, like, we had a couple of us had Kenwoods, but everyone else had Talkabouts. But then the Baofangs. But we've had really good luck with our Puxings and our Baofangs.
We have.
And, for what they cost.
Yeah. But I mean, any FRS radio will work, like a Cobra or
FRS.
Like Cobra or Motorola, as we just talked about. Or any of those knockoffs. So, like, as long as you have decent either mileage or kilometers
The Cobras.
Chris Brand is commenting
cheap
about the Cobras as well. Mike Holstrom says Nextel chirps.
Oh, remember those? Those are like our radios.
I just picture this walkie-talkie giving you lip as you're playing. You call that a shot? Yeah. Yeah, those.
Stay in the car, jerk.
This is not your day, son. Yeah, all the old school name drop, says Andrew. Yeah, so, I don't know. I mean, people are still using the Cobras.
Yeah, I think a lot of the guys who are now doing Milsim, Airsoft, a MagPed, looking for more tactical radio with multiple frequencies. So I think you're right, Joseph. The Baofang or the Puxing. Would certainly meet their needs for that.
Plus, you get those noise canceling headsets that have the boom mics that come out, kind of like what I'm wearing.
Yeah.
Pew, pew.
Yeah, I think a lot of the guys who are now doing Milsim, I'm like a ventriloquist. It's great.
Why are you repeating yourself? You just pulled a Todd.
All right.
How did you do that?
Talent, my friend.
Gavin.
All right, next question comes to us from John Jones. Okay.
No, I'm just looking over at the YouTube chat because we weren't going in there. Dwayne King was saying, you can also monitor other channels with a radio scanner. He says that or tin cans and string. Yeah, and Ryan McGee says, I want sharks with freaking laser beams.
Freaking laser beams.
There we go.
All right. Can I go on with my segment?
It's your segment.
All right. Thanks, man. So John Jones wants to know, what inspired you all to start Behind the Bunker and who came up with the name?
Oh, Christ.
Jesus did?
He did. There was one day I fell in the kitchen on a slippery floor and I looked up and there he was.
It's like, are you using these nails? And we just lost a southern audience.
Was it a waffle stuck to the ceiling?
It was. Thank you. So... why did we start? What? Okay, first of all, why did we start Behind the Bunker? Was that part of the question?
So, what inspired you to start Behind the Bunker, and who came up with the name? Damn it!
I think back when we did it, there were a lot of people in our area that were doing paintball related, like videos and news things. Like Cat Shack was alive, and going at that point. Wolf was doing his thing. No, I meant his channel was. And the Paintball Girl, Haley, there was doing, what was it?
Visual reviews.
Yeah. And it's funny, like all these people were within an hour drive of where we were. And we thought, well, let's try and do something similar to that, but we're going to do it live. And that came after us doing a live broadcast of a local, like of our tournament at our field.
Yeah.
But all we did was literally put a security camera on the field and live streamed it, and people watched it. And it was the worst picture. It was 360. What do you call it? The frame rate's 360.
Yeah.
It was terrible. Whatever, but people watched it, so we thought we'd do that. We got a couple extra webcams, and there we go. We originally wanted to call it Behind the Mask, but out of respect for a local guy who had started his own sort of thing, who had passed on and hadn't used it in years, but we didn't want to take it away from him.
Right.
But he did sort of a website forum, and one of his threads was Behind the Mask, and he would interview local players and stuff like that, and people that he cared that we cared about, and I didn't want to take that away from him. But originally that was my thought, and then I think Joe and I were just spitballing, and
we came up with,
I hit him in the eye, and he said, yeah, Behind the Bunker.
I wish I was behind a bunker.
You had a dog, but we were calling speedball bunkers and hiding in normal paintball bunkers, and I thought we'd just come up with something paintball Behind the Bunker.
Yeah, James Lindsay said 8-bit color. No, that was just, we use MS Paint for all of our graphics.
Yeah,
and that's basically where it started. And we, you know, we've said this a couple times before, but we basically started a weekly program. We used webcams, and then every couple years we'd upgrade. I remember the first year we could honestly say we were high def. We went from standard def to high def, and it was, we lost a lot of viewers when they saw what we looked like.
Yeah. I can see their pores.
Yes.
So that was an interesting answer to the question.
What? We answered it.
Yeah, but you're continuing on. He didn't ask for the whole life story of the
show. I think he did.
Yeah, but some people...
You said y'all. That's everything.
You understand how questions work, right?
Just because you've heard it 6,000 times doesn't mean everybody else hasn't
heard
it.
I'm sure a lot of people in the audience, the diehards...
Matt's just bitter because he wasn't at the first episode.
Bit him too.
Thank you.
All right.
Yeah. And yeah, Wolf's in the live chat. We've said this before. He was one of the first on the first episode. He was one of the first contributors.
And if you are new to the show within the last few years, you can catch up on all the old episodes as well, as Todd slowly uploads them.
Oh God, no.
Shall I?
We got to do it, baby.
Phone call ended. I didn't touch the button. It hung up before I did. Yeah, 585-250-8968 if you guys want to give it a shot.
Do we have the date for the first show? I want to write that down. Wasn't it?
March 11, 2011.
You just made that up.
But he said it with confidence. So
I did. I think it
that.
Was 2011. But it was like the first Monday. Oh, no, sorry. It was the first Tuesday or the second Tuesday in March. I think it was the first Tuesday. So whatever the first Tuesday in March of 11 was, maybe someone could research that. But I think
doing
that's
it right now.
Yeah, and Mike Holstrom says, Matt, someone needs a Snickers.
The second Tuesday was March 14th, and the first Tuesday was March 7th.
So I think it was March 7th.
Why do you have to give Rain Man dates? You know, you can go back.
Because I remember 2011, I remember it was the first Tuesday in March, and we did it Tuesdays because that's when we were at the indoor.
Yeah.
So,
but even with my limited involvement with this program, there were some cringe-worthy moments early on.
There still is. What are you talking about?
But I mean, at least now I'm senile, and it doesn't impact me as much. But there was times where I'm just like, dear God, I can't be seen in public again.
Yeah.
This March, we will have been doing this for 9 years.
Let me take a guess. 447 episodes.
Right now.
Wow, that's some good math.
311 podcasts. Yeah.
Wow. All right, our good friend Brandon Page wants us to move along, and he wants to know out of the four of us, or the three of us, so I guess four, what the hell, who out of the four of us has done the most events in a single year?
Who cares?
Well, it's
Old
not
man Joe.
Yeah, I think I only win that because I've gone to a couple extra events that these guys didn't, like Super Game and whatnot. But otherwise, like Extravaganza, all the other local events, I guess I've done a couple OPL events, but that doesn't really count. So, yeah, I guess.
I would say Todd for sure.
I guess Matt and I. Say, yeah. Matt, Josh, and I.
Yeah.
Now, was that question pertaining to playing or actually physically just being there?
Nobody cares about hanging out. It's like playing.
There's years when we've gone to a bunch of CXBL events and World Cup, and then.
Yeah.
So playing.
Yeah, that's true. You went to World Cup, Matt didn't, so that might trump his super game. So we're getting close.
Like the amount of miles you've traveled? Is that what it is? Or?
Oh, Christ. See how Matt gets involved in this question because he's part of it? Doesn't matter how long we carry on with this nonsensical question, but the other one, oh, my gosh.
No, I like it. We'll keep going. The fans love it.
Yeah. So we need to get to more is basically the longest.
Yeah, I had a hiatus from traveling because I had an ankle bracelet and I couldn't move around much. But yeah, I'm looking forward to doing more events. So Brandon Page, you jerk for calling us all out. I think you'll see us at more and more events. So reach out, buddy.
I have a question here. It says it's from Ted. He says, when did the hopper kicking start?
As soon as hoppers were introduced, I took an aversion to them. So I did not like hoppers at all. And what I like to do is marry my hatred with my love. I hate hoppers. I love seeing kids cry. And so it's a natural marriage to kick hoppers off of kids' birthday parties.
But you're very musical, and the tone of the kid crying versus the flap of the loader leaving the marker and hitting the ground is very harmonious.
Yes, I like to harmonize.
No. Sound like a baby whale.
Hey, Dwayne King in the live chat says, I was on the edge of my seat for Todd's story, just FYI. he also says he's been watching for 6 years, so...
So he knows the story.
Yeah. We're talking about Kevin coming to Fold a Gap, but in all honesty, our budget is stretched already this year, so I don't know if that's going to be an option for
us. GoFundMe.
Yeah, that's true. Roger Weber simply in the live chat says, extravaganza. Everyone else has been saying it wrong.
All right, let's take a look at what else is in my sack.
It's all gooey and dark in here.
Leonard TV Eric wants to know, why don't professional tournaments adopt limited paint formats? It would promote more movement, increase skill, and be cost effective over spray and pray. Why don't they do it?
I think Europe's doing it right now, Matt, right? They're doing limited paint. Yes. Yeah, the M100 or M500, something like that. Yeah. There are tournaments that are doing it, but at the end of the day, not to sound like a businessman, but if you as a player don't shoot paint, that's where the tournament promoter is making their money. Usually the entry fees come off the prices come off the entry fee.
Right.
And all the staffing wages, the insurance, the travel costs, the hotels, all that infrastructure cost usually comes out of the back end, which is just the paint. So if you guys aren't shooting enough paint, the tournament's not making any money, thus you're not having any tournaments or quality tournaments. I mean, anyone can throw a tournament together, but unfortunately, that's the long and short of it.
But wouldn't you like to see a well-produced tournament with limited paint that's underwritten so you don't have to worry about the promoter losing money with it and seeing what people can do with their limited paint?
Yeah, that'd be good. So let's say hypothetically, as Gavin is in the dreamland, let's say...
Yeah.
You can hold a tournament and a successful one at that with only 100 or 500 rounds on your back. Let's say 500 rounds. I think you're going to see way more explosive play. Right. You're going to see it really timid off the break, and then I think you'll see a lot of explosive play.
I think
be far more exciting than what we're seeing right now.
And I think something like that would certainly translate easier for the non-paintball player, saying they have limited shots, and so they have to make the most of it out of all their teams.
Well, you look at MagFed Paintball, and if there was a way to sort of televise that and make it interesting when they would have limited rounds as well, that'd be pretty cool. You'd see a lot of things that you wouldn't normally see because they know they're between mag changes, or they'd have to do something aggressive because there's not a lot of paint in the air. I think...
Yeah.
Gavity's peppering me! Get him off me!
Oh, wait, with the radio.
Breaker. With your bow fang.
Your bow fang.
Yeah.
Or puxing.
So, yeah, I think it'd be pretty awesome.
Yeah, I think it's a wonderful idea. I don't know if promoters are able to do at this point, right? To make it sustainable and to make it profitable so you can pay for referees, compressors, all of that stuff, right? So
Dwayne King wants to know if Gavin's ankle bracelet is a metaphor for wife. No.
I don't have a wife. Ringless, baby.
Yeah.
Wifeless in Seattle.
Yeah.
So yeah. And then on that note, can we talk about compressor for a second?
About my wife?
Well,
I
yes,
just said we don't have one.
Well, we call her the old compressor, right?
The old compressor.
Extrapolate from that what you want,
she's
and I'm just going to leave.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Gavin's pigment is slowly turning a reddish hue, and it's very hard
you
to tell.
Can't tell.
But, yeah. So, from a field owner's and a business owner standpoint, to get you guys air, compressed air, if you've ever been to a big game or looked at your local paintball field's air system, they ain't cheap. They're very expensive. The upkeep's expensive. The filters are expensive. It is a lot of work. Fill stations themselves are not cheap. Yeah, they're compressing air, and I get it. But the diesel and the gas and electricity that's involved in compressing that air and the cost of those units themselves. If you yourself are at home and you've got a compressor in your garage, you're compressing what, Matt? 150 to 200 PSI maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say we're gonna get Matt a mic next week. So let's say you compressed to 300. That ain't 3,000. That ain't 5,000. That's not a lot of anything. So just for what it's worth, I know I'm on a soapbox preaching about how expensive it is, but that's one of the reasons.
A lot of the trends in the U.S. is they charge. If you look at all these events, they're charging for air. All that you can get an all-day air ticket. I think it's 10 or 20 bucks for the weekend or a day. So I think that's something you're going to see. Back, you know, in the early days of paintball, we charged for CO2 because CO2 you had to buy as well.
Yeah. Hey, if you guys are watching us on YouTube right now, let us know how you like it, how the sound and the picture quality is. I know Facebook kind of gets glitchy sometimes, but I want to know how your Facebook is tonight. And Matt, just keep me abreast of the time too.
Mm-hmm.
Our goal is the 53-56 mark.
Yeah.
All right. While we're talking paintball questions at mail time, can I open up a sack that was sent to me this week?
Yes, please.
So this was sent in, and I know who it's from. It's from Mr. John Jones. He sent this weeks ago, actually months ago, but it came from the UK. So it's, I don't know, for some reason, as soon as you try to get something across the ocean, it takes forever and a day.
Either that or it hits an iceberg and sinks.
Gavin?
Shaky, shaky.
Just open that up and see what that is. Oh, look at this. So something I've always wanted is one of these. Sandbagger jersey.
Wow.
But if you look at it, I just saw it. Where did it go? There we go. Signatures. I see Jack Wood's signature. Led's on here. Wow. Look at this. Number 8, number 13.
Wow.
Very cool. Thank you very much. Oh, number John Jones, number 03. I think can you white out things on a jersey?
You can take the stitching out.
I'll put a patch on it or something.
Yeah, we got a patch or a sticker.
Thank you very much, John Jones. I will honestly wear that when I play. That's the Planet Eclipse HDE pattern as well. And on the back of the jersey.
Yeah, into the microphone. That's great.
That's cool.
Nameplate on the back. That's fantastic.
Now, I noticed is there more in the...
There is more in there.
It's empty. I guess the other ones are coming, so...
Oh, I see.
Okay, so. Thanks, Jack. We'll be waiting.
Hey, there's a letter. Did you read the letter?
I did, but I'm going to let you guys...
To all the Behind the Bunker, Merry Christmas from all the sandbaggers. Love what you're doing. Keep up the good work from JJ and obviously the rest.
Excellent. And let's look at what's in this box that was sent.
Oh, look at these stickers.
Oh, nice. Okay, so it's... Oh, there's absolutely nothing. The box is empty.
It wasn't before.
But allow me to sip from my Enola Gay Sandbagger's mug.
Oh, look at the mug. That's cool.
That's the first thing I said when I saw Gavin's. Look at his mug.
And you wanted to sip from it? Ew.
Ew.
All right, let's move along.
Yeah, I'm just tagging John Jones and saying thank you.
Put one on your computer.
So this dead air is fantastic for the RTF Sports Network.
Yeah, so join in every week for more dead air.
Excellent. You know what? Yeah. I think it's time for me to cinch up my sack and close up all of our correspondence that we have. So we have a couple left for next week. But again, my friends, if you have any questions that you would like us to address here on Behind the Bunkers, head to showbehindthebunker.com and we can read it, address it, and butcher it on mail time.
Yeah. All right. I can't find them on Facebook because I'm logged in differently. So I will thank them personally on Facebook later on and share this as well so they know we're going, what's happening.
Chris Brand just said that's every field in the U.S. charges you a day for your air. Interesting. What is the cost per air, Chris Brand, for a day? I'm interested.
I'm also curious if that's the norm in the States or,
I think it
or
is.
Around the world.
I think it is the norm.
Because here locally, your air is included in your entry.
I know.
Some wheels turning.
Yeah.
All right. All four of them.
So Kevin Matthew in the chat says YouTube is running fine. That's great. And seems like YouTube is good. Small audiovisual delay, but that's going to be it there, Fez. And we are working on it as well. And as Gavin suggested before the show, I tested my speed and it was good.
Perfecto?
Yeah. So a couple of weeks ago, it wasn't Facebook as much as it was Rogers. We didn't know at the time, but Rogers was having some serious issues in our area.
And we
had
have
dropped.
Been Rogered in the past. And
we definitely have been
slightly Rogered last a few weeks ago. So,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. So thank you for putting up with it. So I want to watch the live chat, guys. We're going to ask you guys tonight questions, and it is this. What is the best piece of paintball gear that you've had? And also, what is the worst? Just label it in the chat. This is my best. This is my worst. Or just whatever. And I want to go through your social media stuff that you guys have, because a lot of you guys sent us in through Facebook and Instagram. But can we not... One thing I want to do tonight, because we don't have our visuals, let's go slow and read them one at a time instead of blasting three or four, because there's a couple in there, especially on some of the sheets you guys have that are really good.
Yeah, and just for our friends from the RTF Sports Network, Bill Barnes writes in the Pro Edition Pump Carnivore. That's his best. His worst, a clear 50 Brass Eagle Hopper.
Nice.
A hard ball pierced right through it.
Jeez.
I have seven I would like to read. I've selected.
Oh, but not in a row, though. Read one at a time,
like
and we'll comment.
You don't like my voice?
Did you miss the briefing?
No, I know. I was re-listening to our podcast this week, and we all kind of read them so quick that listing and rewind, a couple of them we should have elaborated on because some of them were really good.
Okay.
But yeah. You don't pay attention to the show anyway.
Russ Carroll, best.
I was going to say something, but I couldn't. Yeah.
His A5 with response trigger was the best.
Yeah.
That's his name is Russ Carroll and the best. So A5 response, and his worst is Psycho Ballistics Cocker.
I will agree. How many of those did we have through the shop, Joe, that they come in and they look so fancy? I'll give them that. They were the spider of cockers. Like, they looked fancy. They had all the bells and whistles added to it. And when I mean bells and whistles, I guess I mean like aesthetic things, like spoilers for no reason,
yeah,
right?
They look good.
They were terrible. And like, for those of you that love them, I apologize, but they were the crappiest things to fix.
They weren't even WGP parts. They were all these offshore things. Nothing fit.
And his A5 comment, I have to say, I've seen so many people, especially Tippmann is really hammering home right now. The guys are posting pictures of them playing with their A5s. I don't know if there's an A5 resurgence right now or if there's just so many of them right now where they almost seem to oversee
the guys are probably getting into their
returning back
and their gun of choice was an A5.
Colonel Devin Schwarzkopf in the chat says A5 response trigger. Yeah.
Here's a new one. Bob Spicer, his best was his Warp Sports Dark Angel LCD.
Oh, nice.
And the worst so far is his TM50. Never had a gun that needed so much tuning, including magazine. It has forums full of technical questions, yet people seem to love them. It's a pretty wall hanger.
Yeah. Matt was basically brainwashed, and he's part of the... Yeah.
He had some Kool-Aid?
He had some Kool-Aid. Mike Holstrom in the live Facebook chat says, the best is the GOG multi-caliber hopper. And he says the worst is knee pads, anybody's knee pads.
Oh.
I will agree. Wow. I've been through several different knee pads and haven't really found one that doesn't either slide down or is too tight or... Yeah.
And you've developed calluses over the years from kissing ass. So.
I have knee pads. My BDU pants have pockets built in for the knee pads, and I put a knee pad in those, and they just work fine. They
have
move
I said
around.
How nice you look, Gavin?
Those calluses in action.
Yeah.
Joe Kimson filled out a forum. The Brass Eagle Nightmare is the worst.
Okay.
I had one of the first ones that Gino and Aldo put together in Aldo's basement, and the thing, when you fired it, went something like an elephant gun. It was crazy, but it was all solid brass. And when it shot like you've never seen anything shoot like through a wood tree.
On your carpet?
Because Bukkake ruined it. And then my favorite product was CalMag Solar Pink Paint. Best paint, best fill, and best packaging.
I'm going to argue with that and say my best favorite paint was Marbleizer.
No way. You never
when
shot,
it was good.
You never I shot like Solar Pink.
No, but to me, the best paint I ever shot was the Marbleizer.
And Robin Roberts Best says, Robin Roberts.
You can't have
best.
The same name.
An old tribal Mephisto 2.2 modded, accurate and rips. The worst, a coiled remote line that blew out the first time he used it.
There's a lot of Shiza remote lines out there. We've seen them out there. Like, if you're going to buy a remote line, guys, don't take the risk. Buy either a Ninja or a Pure Energy. Like, buy a good quality one. Don't buy any,
knockoff Chinese remote lines.
Steve,
not good.
Steve self in the live chat says best was his viruses. Warlock autococker, and the worst was his JT speed loader system.
That was a slam pack.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
I saw one of those elsewhere too. The slam pack was not a favored item.
And our good friend Christopher Delicious Pringle says his best piece of gear that he owned.
He lives in a can. Pringles, get it?
Owns my ball wall. What the hell's a ball wall?
So it's what you wear in front of your nut sack. You let it hang out. Yeah, I saw his picture.
Okay. Yeah. I have a mangina, so I wouldn't know.
That's like one of those things that you put on your plate carrier.
Gavin catches with his mangina and cups them and then puts them back in his loader.
All right. Well, thank you for clarifying what that is. And the worst piece he ever owned was a remote line. Again, a remote line. Sounded like a good idea at the time.
Okay, here we go. Shelby Spear only has his best. Buying behind the bunker legacy tights.
Oh, Jesus! Chris Brand says the best have ever. His best thing he's ever had is the Exalt Barrel Rocket Squeegee. Yeah, I'll give you that. That's a good one too. Best. So did someone read Chris Jr.'s in the live chat? He says 2001 Dark Angel.
Nope.
And the worst was the EVO Egg, the Evolution Egg.
Yeah, maybe. Tommy Gunn's Apex Barrel and an Apex Barrel, best and worst. Oh, look at Todd Ansage. Evil Omen was the worst, and the best is the Empire Axe.
Empire Axe, as much as I want that plus cash, every time I pulled it out of the bag, it works. It works well.
You got that blue pill.
The one time I had to put a new battery in, just because like I had never done it before. But every time you pull it out, put air through it, it worked. So absolutely. Bill Barnes says Marb was awesome. And then Roger Weber says the Model 98, meat and potatoes, worst. Oh, it was the best. And the worst is the E3 Dragon. Only worked right for worked 1 week a year. And that's when it was hot outside.
Our good friend Greg Muller says best piece of equipment is a two-way tie. So stay tuned, folks. One is the unique sports gear team travel bag. It hasn't let him down once in 28 years of play. Or his also another best is the V-Force Profiler lens in Windex blue, not mirrored. So sun, shade, transition, indoor, best color lens he's ever used. Picked up everything. Nice. Now, wait.
Uh-oh.
Here's his worst. Worst piece of equipment, again, a two-way tie. His Tasso rat tail swab used one time and it gave away.
Nice.
And or the Psycho Ballistics adjustable bore barrel.
Oh, yeah,
two pieces of equipment that he hated.
Little Wolfie Critchlow in the live chat says, my Sly goggles fogged in 35 seconds. Not only did they fog in 35 seconds, you were left to say, what? They were so loud, they were like wearing, it's like putting two blankets on each of your ears. Yeah. The worst goggles ever.
But comfortable.
Yeah. George, hey, best BTB leggings, worst not having them. Listen, George, hey.
Come extravaganza, that'll change.
Yeah, Wolf said his best is the full clip tactical vest.
I know we joke about it, guys, but do you feel a little sick about that image?
I threw up a little in my mouth, and I wasn't sure if I'm coming down with some of the China flu or if it's...
or it's just an image of George A. prancing around.
Yeah. Virik in the live YouTube chat says, best was Pink Premium.
Oh, yeah, RP Sheer.
I'm not good. Yeah, that's... we've had some really nasty fill Pink RP Sheer paint that was super awesome.
Or is he talking about the KP2, the two-tone pink?
Well, we'll ask him. But he says the worst was Monster Balls.
Right.
Kevin says the best is his 2011 G6R, and the worst was Scott's Badass Mask.
Oh, Scott's Mask, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The best, according to Fez, is the Zodiac Renegade ZR1, and the worst, the Spider MR2. Yeah, I would put almost, I might even say both those in the same category.
Yeah, they're both worst. Yeah. Jordan Christensen, the best is the Tippmann Cronus, and the worst is the 468. And Matt's flailing.
And John Maskin says the best is his Bob Long signature autocockers, worst is the PT Extreme that never worked right to begin with.
Yeah, how many of those did we fix?
None.
How many?
Okay, I guess, okay, attempted. Yeah. Rhodey's Paintball says, hands down, the worst marker I've purchased was the Dangerous Powers F8.
Okay. Yeah, they were notoriously crappy.
He says they were supposed to be the ego killers. Beautiful milled turning markers with half the price.
I'll crush your ego, all right. Yeah.
Mine came straight from the factory and looked the part. but when I aired it up the first time, the reg just said, nope, and leaked right away. After three rebuilds, the marker still couldn't make it through a hopper without something going wrong. I'm pretty sure my brain repressed this memory because for the life of me, I couldn't recall what happened to this POS, but I don't know. But I do know that it broke down and I got an ego shortly thereafter. Yeah. Bricks Mini Mayhem says best and worst is a Metadyne Thumper. 64 Time Machine says the best was his DM6 and the worst was his Velocity Loader. Funniest thing was Halo upgrade loader boards give you the feed rate of 30 balls per second. Turn your Halo into a mini blender. Yeah. But I have to say the DM6 though, and I apologize to crap on die. And we ran a store that had a lot of repair service center for people to come in. Every gun that came in, like DM6, you'd have guys that swear that they had the best, and you'd have other guys that had the worst. And that was with every make and model for a number of years there. And I'm not saying it was 50-50. By far, it was not. There was a lot of good ones, but there was a couple that, like, no matter what we did, Dai just kept sending us parts and parts and parts, and then finally they just said, okay, send the whole gun, and they replaced it. But, But, whatever. I'm sure they sold so many of them that whatever. Little Mikey 1969 says the worst thing is anything Valken, and the best is probably his JT Proflex.
Yes.
Yeah, I will agree on the Proflex.
Luco says best paintball Zap Chronic Ultimate custom ball for the Iron Man with glitter, and the worst
glitter.
The worst because he used to go to raves. Well, and they stuff in Saskatchewan,
work hard, but Gavin,
and
they play even harder. Yep.
And the worst ball was Banner Fama paintballs from Alberta.
Yeah.
But Banner also made, that's where the CalMag was, Banner Pharmaceuticals out of California. Yeah. Interesting.
Little known fact.
Now, I'm going to take the last one if you guys are okay with that.
Yeah, man, it's your show.
Someone named Jack Woods posted up. He says the best thing is Planet Eclipse guys. Did you know that they are the creators of the most incredible tournament paintball markers, soft goods, and gear? Come on, you didn't honestly know what that was going on.
No,
with that.
But it was a wonderful segue. Nice. Loved it.
Guys, they have the winningest paintball markers in paintball, and now they are innovators in mechanical actions like the new M170R and the new MG100 MagFed Marvel. Guys, check them out at your local retail store.
EG is the world's leading manufacturer of smoke grenades, thunderflash, airsoft, and paintball grenades for use in theater, film, photography, and of course, paintball. Pull a tab at your next event. Hashtag pop smoke.
And Arrows are proudly made in the United States of America. Their thick welded seams, stainless steel hardware, multiple color options, and layouts are available. 2020 is here, and their fields are shipping. Ask about full color printing and custom logos, logo options. Customize your next field with Arrows.
Mike Holstrom says groan. Come on, that was good.
That was awesome.
It was okay. Ruthless Paintball Products caters to both professional players and weekend warriors. They have set a new level of paintball playing apparel. You can head on over to their website and use our BTB15 promo code for 15% off their products.
More than just swabs and packs.
Oh, shit, that's me.
Zolt is a way of life. Available at discerning retailers, fields, shops, and shows. Tournament ready, battle proven. Thank you, Gavin. In the beginning, you fell out of a tree. You stumble down a rocky cliff. You wade chest deep through a mosquito-infested bog, and you realize you're surrounded. It's party time. You own a Tippmann now, combined Empire, JT, Tippmann, and V-Force, and you get the world's largest distributor of everything paintball, GI Sports.
Very good. DLX Technologies, guys. Manufacturer of the Lux paintball marker, as well as other great product lines like the SP Shocker, the GOG Enemy, and the Freak Barrel Kits, just to name a few. They are the longtime paintball manufacturer, but they have the gear that you can trust, and their gear is outstanding, guys. Make sure you check out DLX Technologies and all of their offerings at your local retail store.
For over 50 years, Altama has proudly carried militaries from across the globe through every challenging environment, including malls, jungles, deserts, urban battle zones. Make Altama your next paintball, airsoft, or EDS everyday shoe. Or look for Altama Original SWAT and First Tactical at a leading retailer near you. Hashtag no drip, no melt.
So not all ninjas wear black. Wow. With advanced colorways and coatings, adjustable regulators, remote lines, fill stations, hydro testing, and more, Ninja products have what it takes to keep you out front and always in the game. Made in America and always full of air.
Yeah, yeah. Chris Jr. Rossi in the live chat says, my Axe 2.0 is a dumpster fire at the moment. Nothing but trouble. I don't know. I guess every marker has their bad ones, but I've always had really good luck. And Devin Schwartz says, not all heroes get microphones.
Someone said, well, Wolf said, why in over is it over 9 years Matt can't have a microphone? Matt has a microphone. Look, Wolf.
There's two Matts back here.
So, yeah. So
there's two Matts.
Okay, I got to level with you. I'm bad with names, Wolf. And we needed an extra person to help out in the show. And we got a gentleman. His name is Matt.
Matt Mondu.
That's right. You've met him before. So when I saw him, I thought, well, if I bring him on board, then I only have to say Matt and learn Matt because I already know that name.
Like my brother Daryl, my other brother Daryl.
Yeah. So it's kind of nice. And then the thing is now it's like double trouble because I say, hey, Matt, and both of them look up. It's like, hey, this is cool.
But it's sort of a Penn and Teller vibe. Right?
Yeah, that's true.
One speaks, the other one just sort of nods.
Yeah, that's
one
true.
One gets paid more.
All right. Sorry. What is the time, Matt? Clarify. You could say it on air.
No.
I couldn't see your... Okay,
51.
I could,
oh, wait, 52.
Matt's trying to give me Navy foot signals right now, and I don't know. So just to reiterate, guys, if you guys want to win the carbon the carbon pack, which... I don't know where it got to. I lost my carbon image. If you guys want to win the carbon pack, all you have to do is tag behind the bunker, tag carbon, and tag a friend. That's it. And we'll catch all those tags. We're going to put them in a generator next week, and we're going to announce it on next week's show who gets to win that. So
don't be
cost
disappointed
anything.
When the name Gavin Sharma is called as the winner of the pack.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not a pack guy. I got to be careful how that comes out, but I'm not a pack guy. all right.
I get it.
But, he's tobagging.
You know, yes, but as a speedball player, I think this would be the pack that you want to get onto your body.
Okay, screw speedball players. This pack is good for anybody. Okay, yes, if you're a Milsim guy and you want to keep the look, I get that. But this is a comfortable pack. I play recreational paintball. I like a 4+3 on my back. I think it's...
I wore mine to the market the other day. I carried water bottles in it. I put some cucumbers in it. Man, it was the greatest pack of all.
I remember being a young man and having a pack on to parties. And they hold beverages quite nicely
they
to
do.
Transport around.
Look at you. You're an innovator.
Wolf Critchlow says that you sound like you're under a blanket when you do
Matt,
your reads.
Matt.
It's not. He's actually underwater. We waterboard him.
Yeah.
That keeps him in line.
Keeps him hydrated.
Well, that's what we tell him.
We don't actually waterboard. We pickleboard with pickle
with
juice.
With Hydrodil.
Yeah.
Not pickle milk, right?
I'm not going to pick on the newbie, but I do like the guys that wear their pod packs frontwards on their stomachs.
Well, when I drive,
and they turn them upside
around.
Down because they're trying to mimic the guys they see with pot, like with vests and stuff. Yeah. And I get that, and it's fine. I guess any way you really want to wear it. So,
and as long as people are playing paintball, who cares what they wear and how they wear it? Let's get some people out playing paintball.
Hey, so if you guys are listening to us on RTF Sports Network, if you guys are listening to us on the radio and want to know what the hell have you been listening to, this is a paintball podcast. We do it every week. We broadcast live on Facebook Live as well simultaneously live on YouTube. So if you want, subscribe to either of those platforms so you don't miss out on a show. If you don't have time to sit there and watch it, if you have ADD and you can only tune in for a couple of minutes, I get that. download it. We are in podcast form, basically anywhere that you get your better podcast. So guys, we're going to end this show. If you guys are watching us live, thank you very much for tuning in. If you guys want to continue to watch us live, we're going to continue to stream over there on YouTube. So jettison Facebook, jump over to YouTube, and you can watch the after show. Guys, thank you very much for tuning in. We'll see you next week.
Don't be a freeloader. If you liked what you hear, make sure to hit the share button below. Also follow us on our social media outlets like Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, ICQ, and now MySpace. If you want to join the conversation, post your comments and we might read them on the show.
Use an old iPad.
Yeah, you know what? I have one. Why don't we do that? There we go. That's about all that my good old my iPad is for.
We're live!
Oh, stop! But here, I'll ask you guys on YouTube right now. I have an old iPad. It's the first generation iPad that came out. What the heck do you use it for anymore?
I thought you were going to try and sell it.
You can't. Well, for...
Well, I want to find out what it's good for first before I can put a price together.
Not a whole lot, because you can't even update the software anymore.
No, they don't support
it. You're querying
it.
My deal.
Yeah, I mean, it's, what can't you use it for?
What can't you? Exactly. All right, so we'll just wait a few more moments for more guys to jump over to YouTube Live here and check in. So thank you guys for tuning in. While we're waiting for you guys to come over, I'm going to tell you guys I had an opportunity.
I want to find out what's
sorry.
Good for.
There we go. Turn it off. It's Gavin chiming again. So I had an opportunity to go to the movie theater for the first time in I can't remember how long, and I had an opportunity to watch The Gentlemen, Guy Ritchie movie.
And?
I had no idea what the movie was, and I love going into a movie when I don't know because I hate watching the previews because the previews just give it away. I'm going to say, in all honesty, my rating is the best movie I have seen at a movie theater in probably 10 years.
Okay. So that's
I put that up with Pulp Fiction. Okay, remember the first time you saw Pulp Fiction?
So I've heard some hype around it. It was supposed to be the gangster movie that should have been The Irishman. Yeah. So The Irishman should have had this quality.
So have you ever seen... The Kingsman? Kingsman movies? Okay, so...
Not all of it. I've seen maybe 15 minutes of it.
Okay, so...
Didn't appeal.
The conversation... So I equate the movies to Pulp Fiction. You can close your eyes and just listen to the conversation. It's so well written. It's just enjoyable. And that's what I did there. But it's so prim and proper. And the way they talk about things, because it's very sort of innuendo, but not sexually, but innuendo in reference to how they're going to hurt each other or what's going to happen. It's all code, but you kind of get what they're talking about. It's just brilliant.
Okay.
And I sat there speechless through the whole movie. I thought it was fantastic.
I would hope you were speechless through the whole movie.
Yeah, this ain't movie ain't good. No, but
throwing
it was
burritos at the screen.
But it was really good. If you're gonna go see one movie, I'm probably overhyping it, but I won't go back to the movie to watch it. But as soon as it comes out in some sort of way that I can watch it, I'm gonna sit down and watch it again. Much like The Irishman was really good, but it was really long. I figured they probably could have took an hour out of that, but I would say that this holds more weight than The Irishman does for sure.
Okay, good, great. So yeah. I think the same excitement and enthusiasm you have for this movie is what I was hoping for The Irishman. So
yeah.
I've heard really good things, so I'm glad that Todd, you hate everything.
I hate everything. I don't, Mike.
You enjoyed this, so I may check it out.
I like everyone else in the studio.
Have you watched Treadstone yet, Gavin?
No, I only have Netflix.
I thought you
it's
have
on
Amazonian
Prime.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. I'll give you my password.
Yeah. Just don't look in as recently watched. Wow. Wow.
Holy fool.
I may break down and get Prime too, but.
Yeah. Treadstone is really good. I found the first couple episodes, the Origin series, fantastic. Then it kind of goes weird, but it is good. I would definitely watch the whole thing.
Then you can watch Jack Ryan too. Two seasons of that. That's like a good.
Have you watched the English version of that?
Jack Ryan?
No, it's Jackford Ryan.
Oh, Jackford
Ryan. Yeah, it takes place in the UK and yeah.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
No. So,
No.
Move on. Why don't you guys move on when I'm not bombing? So there we go. So anyways, thank you guys for tuning into the regular show. Thank you guys for sending all your questions. We had a plethora of questions tonight. Did you finish them all or was
there
more?
No, there's a few questions. So we will certainly get to that next week.
Save it for next
week. And again, if you are our podcast friends and you're only listening to us, send an email at showbehindthebunker.com with your question and we will certainly address that here on the after show, and you can enjoy that during your commute or whatever else you do or how you listen to your podcast.
Yeah, yeah. And I apologize to you guys that are watching us live. We had a malfunction. As I say, our new intern, Matt Mondu, basically screwed us. But we didn't have an opportunity to do our Price is Right, our Mag Fetish. We had a team that we were going to feature tonight. We had Paintball Around the World. And there was a bunch of other stuff we were going to get to. There was a great video as well that I really, really wanted to show you guys. But we'll do it next week, and I'm sure you've seen it, but I do want to talk about it. And Chris Havoc in the live YouTube chat says, yeah, that was an awesome movie. Kevin Matthews says, just take a picture of Gav and set it in the background and use it for target practice. That's not very nice.
Nobody would.
I mean, I do it.
Nobody would
hate
this beautiful specimen.
And Ted Wright says, The Witcher. You guys seen any of that?
I saw a few of the episodes of it. My little person played the video game and thoroughly enjoyed it. So that was on for hours at our home. And then she wanted to really watch the TV show. And it, as a fan of the game, she loved it. And she loves the series as well. So.
Oh, nice.
Chris Havoc in the live Facebook or YouTube chat says, thanks a lot, Matt.
Yeah,
Mom,
see, until he gets it right, we're not giving him a microphone. That way he can't defend himself. I'm super stoked. Titman TMC is in the mail, says Gerald. You know what? You made a good decision, my friend.
Indeed.
Yeah.
I'm very slouchy on video this week.
Are you watching yourself in the rewind?
And in real life.
Why you gotta be like that?
We are still visual, so you may want to put your fingers down.
Oh, sorry.
No, that's okay.
I'm gonna sit up.
It does ask us when we go live if this is a kid appropriate video.
I'm gonna. Oh, does it?
Even what happened? Oh, did you just mute me? You sure did. Matt figured out how he can get back to us. All right. Well, why don't we probably end this nonsense right now? Guys, I apologize again for all the technical issues. We will have it fixed and sorted out for next week. But at least Rogers didn't Roger us this week. Gavin, where do you go back and watch the show? Do you listen to the show? What do you do with them?
A little column A, a little column B. So I do watch the show typically the day or two afterwards. And sitting at my desk, getting some paperwork done, and I pop the show on, and I'm thoroughly embarrassed each and every week that I can't stop myself.
Yeah, well, there's nothing you can do about your look. That's the way you were
no,
born.
No, but which is why I translate very well to podcasts. Yeah.
And that's why I said tonight we need to slow down the topic, and I think it worked. Like, I really think a lot of you guys are giving us good insight, and sometimes we skip over it quickly. But tonight, I don't know, what did you guys think?
How the topic,
I was hoping to leave it dead air.
The topic was slower. It's fine. I think it was a good.
Because sometimes guys make good comments, and not all the time. You guys aren't always on fire, but when you guys are,
why you gotta be like that?
Why you gotta be like that?
Yeah. All right. Well, why don't we end this nonsense? I still have two or three more hours to train Matt before he leaves tonight. So we'll let you guys go. Joe, thank you for being on the program.
Thanks very much for tuning in, guys. If you're out and about tomorrow night, come by Flaggeters Indoor. We're doing another time trials. Don't forget to come to Red Dawn 15 Wolverines on Sunday, March the 1st at Flaggeters Outdoor.
Yeah.
Boom.
And Joe's not shirtless. That's just his tan shirt if you guys want adjusting your
it's
screen right now.
It's actually called British Khaki is the color.
British?
Khaki.
Very good. All right, and thank to the Mats in the production Mats. Studio.
To answer your question earlier, I only listen to the podcast when you guys are waterboarding me. So,
yeah, we still get the best hits from Guantanamo. All right, guys, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. We'll see you guys next week. Don't forget to hit that subscribe wherever you watch.